In this question, it is given that this CP is a wavefront, and this AO and BP, these are perpendicular to the wavefronts. These are rays of light. This is a plane mirror. The ray of light AO, it reflects from O, and OP is the reflected ray. The angle of incidence and reflection are theta respectively. It is asked that what should be the value of theta so that at P a constructive interference takes place. This distance is d perpendicular from the mirror. For convenience, we can draw a perpendicular as this is d. So from the this triangle, we can say that if this is theta, then this should be also theta. Then OP, this is d, so OP can be written as d times sec theta. So d sec theta. Now in this triangle, once OP is calculated, let us calculate OC. Here this angle is 2 theta and OP is known. So therefore OC by OP is equal to cos 2 theta. So OC will be equal to OP multiplied by cos 2 theta. That is d sec theta and cos 2 theta. This is OC. Now at point P, constructive interference to take place, the path difference should be n times lambda, where n may be any number 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Now what is the path difference? The path difference at point P, this ray is straightforward going, and the path difference starts from here. It is equal to CO plus OP. Now CO is d sec theta cos 2 theta plus OP. OP is d sec theta. We can take d sec theta common for our convenience. So it will be 1 plus cos 2 theta. For further simplicity, d sec theta, and this is 2 cos square theta. D sec theta and 2 cos square theta. One of the sec theta and cos theta cancels, so it will be 2d cos theta. This is path difference. And this path difference should be equal to, for constructive interference, this 2d cos theta, it should be equal to n lambda. Now one more thing we are missing here. Let's just observe the path difference CO and OP. But problem is that as it is getting reflected, there will be a phase change of pi, so that the path difference is further increased by lambda by 2. So we should add a lambda by 2 here. So once we add a lambda by 2 plus lambda by 2 here, the path difference comes out to be this. So when this quantity for constructive interference, the path difference should be equal to n lambda. So 2d cos theta plus lambda by 2 is n lambda. So 2d cos theta is n lambda minus lambda by 2. So this will be lambda n minus half. From there, let's check. Cos theta is equal to lambda divided by 2d n minus half. Now if it is an objective question, you have to check for the value of n. If suppose we cannot put n equal to 0, because it will become cos theta as negative, that is not admissible. So n cannot be 0, then n is equal to 1, then cos theta will be equal to lambda by 2d into half, that is lambda by 4d. Similarly, the other options are n can be 2, 3, etc. But if it's an objective question with multiple choice, we need to check the values which will be most appropriate for that answer. So as of now, cos theta is this, but n cannot be 0. That's the solution.